So today's the day. I think I'm gonna try to stick this super pipe on here. Yeah, so that's better already. Look, it's tweaking the whole frame if I push it back. That's crazy. Wow, look at the chain. You see the chain, watch. Wow. Huh. No wonder the chain flops around sometimes and hits this. This whole frame is very flexible. Yeah, I think I'm gonna maybe bend this tab, heat it up and bend it, or, well, I'm gonna get the panel and see how that fits first. Yeah, I could put that in between. Oh no, that hits if I do that. Huh. Doesn't fit very well. So that's like, that doesn't fit like that, so I'm gonna have to put it there. But if I do that, this hits here. And it's still pretty far away up there. Let's see. That's hitting there though. I don't really like that. This should be cut out a little more or something. Well, let's see what happens. Yeah, that's not really. Yeah, it's not really lining up very good. But it does line up. Maybe if I tighten it down, it'll just bend. I'm gonna have to put a washer in there, because look at the bike. The whole bike twist. So I think I'm gonna put another washer in there. There. So I got three washers in there. It looks like about, I mean, who knows, yours might be different, but I'll just show you what's going on with mine. It's about 4.5 millimeters. That's already at quite a bit of an angle going this way. So I don't know if you can tell with this warped camera here that, you know, the lens makes everything look crazy, but you can see that there's quite a bit of space there. And if I force it over, the whole bike, the engine wants to twist the frame and stuff. So I think I'd rather have it like this. If I can get this bolt in here, I'll be happy. I might have to buy a longer one of these. Catch a thread without cross-threading it, I'd be happy. I think I did. I think it's still hitting it right there, but it's all right. I got some paint. I think it's a little too dark, but I got some stuff that looked closer when I bought it in the store and came home, and it was way too light, and this is the next darkest one they had. It's a little darker, but it's a Chinese mini bike. What you gonna do? Yeah, now yours could be a little different. Who knows? Your frame could be different. Your pipe could be different. This could be cut out a little different. You know, these are probably made on some kind of a jig, and who knows, you know, when they weld stuff, it bends a little bit, but. Should I give a little start just to see what it sounds like? Sounds good so far. I wonder what that's gonna do to the feel of the vibrations, because I think this thing's rubber mounted. The engine is rubber mounted, and now you're kind of connecting it to the frame with some metal. And I guess these are just rubber, or these are just bushings, not bearings, which I didn't know until somebody made a post on Facebook about changing these to real bearings. It took three certain kind of a bearing.
I guess these are, you know, this frame rail is mounted with bushings or rubber, which helps with smoothness, but probably not with precision of the handling,
but it does okay. You get used to it. It is a little squirrely at first compared to a hardtail where everything's rigid. It does feel a little squirrely, but you get used to it, so. All right, so I just had to undo this, and this slipped right off. Had to get that one off of there, and then this one. See, I could put a breather on here and just attach it up under the seat or something. This might determine what I want to do with this vent. See, this thing comes way down. It's much better protection for mud than all this. And I haven't really taken this in any mud yet, but I'm sure I will. So, yeah, that'll be nice. Okay, so I got these. Apparently one of these is bigger. Yeah, see? So this is a small one. With a big one? No, that's still too small for that, but I think I have a tube that'll fit in between. So now the gas tank is vented. I could just stick it here, but I don't know. I kind of like the idea of putting it up here, zip tying it up there out of the way. So I'm going to try to just see how this thing runs. It's probably going to run like crap, but I'm going to see how this thing runs with, you know, just sticking the filter on there and just see what happens. Now I can always drop this down and stick some more, you know, stick another jet in there or whatever. Just to see what happens, I'll just stick it on there. Yeah, I'm going to have to stack some washers or something. So I don't know if you can see in there, but I just used some oversized nuts that slid over those studs coming out. And they fit, you know, inside this cutout. And I just use those basically as spacers. Okay, I don't over tighten them, but if it's running like crap, you might want to check these. Okay, now let me get this thing. And you can always take this thing and just bend it too, you know. Bend it, smoosh it down a little bit. Yeah, these things are a little bit tight on these. What I did last time, I put one of these on my CT200 UEX and it's working great. I didn't oil it. I don't know if you're supposed to oil it or not, but I didn't. But I took this off completely to get it on there because it was, it's really tight. And once you do get it on there, it doesn't feel like it's all the way on there, but as long as you get one ridge over here so you can put that band on, it stays on. In fact, I think I'm gonna sit this right out here in the sun and let that get hot for a few minutes. Now, this one seems to be doing pretty good. I'm gonna have to take this off here and see how much dust is in there, and if there is dust, I'm gonna have to oil this, and then who knows how good it'll work, but it works. I can't tell the difference between this and the and these style. As far as, you know, how the engine feels or the power or anything like that, but that's without any oil on this and that's with oil on that. But some of these don't require oil. They're not supposed to be oiled. So yes, I had one of these. The very first one of these kits I got from Go Power Sport, it came with these little orange pieces of tubing and that fits perfect right there. Should be all right. All right, let's see how this thing's going. Oh, got into a shadow there. See if I can stretch it on here. Yeah. There it goes. Not exactly a perfect fit, but you put a clamp on there, it doesn't go anywhere. Plus, it's much less likely to get knocked around because it's so low profile. Yeah, these pipe clamps or band clamps, whatever you want to call them, they're pretty much garbage. I got some better ones over there I bought that I think are better. I don't know.
You don't want to do them too tight or they'll just bend these and everything will break. But yeah, I think that's on there pretty good.
Now it might run like dog crap because this will be probably a lot more airflow. The reason why it's smoking is because I just tried to start it a bunch of times without the spark plug on there. Yeah, it's running lean. See? They're running half choke. If I turn the choke off, see?
All right, I have not rejetted yet. I'm just gonna take it for a quick spin. Got the stage one kit on it, super pipe, but I need to rejet it. I think it's running lean. It needs a 38 jet, I think, which I'm gonna do right after I take it for a spin.
It's got more power. I'm gonna go throw that 38 jet in there. Maybe a 140 emulsion tube if I have one.
Got these little vice grips on the fuel line there. It's gonna maybe just take this the carb bowl off of here. Dump some gas in here. Yeah. So this is a 38 jet. I think this is a 140 emulsion tube. Because if you compare it to that one, which I think is stock. See that hole up there? That hole on the top is a lot bigger. So let's hope this one is easy to take off of here. Could have done it on the bike pretty easy, but whatever, I'll just do it here. All right, so let's break that. There we go. Let's pay attention to how they come out of here. Okay, so that is a small jet. Tell by looking at it. Okay, so yeah, it's a stock emulsion tube. It looks the same there. It's got a little bigger hole going through it. And the stock one seemed to have more holes running up and down this tube, but this one has a giant hole down there. Ooh, it looks like it has a ridge too. Never noticed that, but anyway. So I'm gonna put the 140 in there and the 38 jet. If this runs too rich or something, I'll just put a 36 in or a 37. I think I got some of those. I even got some 35s and 34s. Okay. Make sure this rubber gasket's good. Looks good. So I put that gasket back there. See how that hole goes up there? Oh, that's right. These studs, I saw them moving. I'm gonna make a jam nut and tighten those up. Yeah, I could see them spinning when I was loosening that up, so. So they're jammed together, and I'm going to take this one. See it twisting? Yeah. So that was loose for some reason. Why is it so loose? Man, it just keeps going. Feels weird. I'm going to take this all the way out and just see if those threads are messed up or something. I'm just curious because something feels weird about this. It's all right. All right. It seems like I'm pushing my luck trying to tighten that up. It just feels weird. I don't know why. Okay. That doesn't look like it's going anywhere. I don't think that's going anywhere. It's pretty cool. All right, let's see if it runs. This thing wasn't on there right. Glad I had my hand on the brake. Yeah, there we go. This wasn't on right. And I am glad that I had my hand on the brake right then, because when I popped that off, it tried to go full throttle. I'm gonna start this up against a wall just because something weird happened. So I mean, it looks okay, but this was just jammed. It wasn't all the way down on there. I'm still going to do this up against the wall with a brake on. There. Whoa! Alright, I don't have any gear on. I'm just going to take it easy. Motors. Let's start right here. See how good it goes. Starting uphill. That's how I want this thing to run. Sounds mean too. Maybe not today. I'll get my gear on and do a timed run up here. I'm actually struggling for traction. I'm testing out a new mic here. Hopefully this microphone isn't sounding terrible.
Yeah, this puppy's got some torque, man. Nice. I don't need no stinking choke. I think a front brake would be a wise choice now. Because this thing's got some pretty good power. Build speed up pretty fast now.